Age 726, Planet Plant. A bully seems to be harassing a young boy. The youngster doesn't take the abuse lying down and tells the punk to bring it. Dashing forward, the bully lands several hits on the lad, knocking him to the ground and continuing to verbally berate him. The boy throws sand in the jerk's eyes before grabbing him by the tail and kicking him in the obvious place, and this effectively ends the fight. Two nearby Saiyans who greatly resemble Scarface and Shorty take exception to this, calling his integrity into question. The young man responds by saying, "You said it yourself. I'm a weakling. I don't get the luxury of fighting honorably because I either win or die. I don't get to have a fighting spirit. So the next time you want to pick on me, just remember I don't play fair." For whatever reason, the pair abruptly run off. Thinking little of it, the boy hears someone calling his name from behind, which turns out to be the titular Vaboru. It's his cousin, Paprika. She inquires to his injuries and he explains that it was Maisu's rotten gang again. The two get into a humorous back and forth and she tells him that Uncle Veggie has challenged King Kibosha to a duel. In a barren wasteland, what appears to be a hulky Vegeta takes center stage as the kids make their way through the crowd. Turns out, Fat Vegeta is actually Kibosha, who seems less than pleased about the situation. The actual Saiyan named Vegeta kicks up a cloud of dust. We find out Kibosha killed Vegeta's father 30 years ago, but he feels if his father was so pathetic to fall to a weakling like Kibosha, then he deserved to die. Blindly throwing punches, Kibosha can't seem to find his opponent. Vegeta hates everything this man represents. Kibosha is a selfish, self-indulgent man, and he decides very abruptly to end his life. Kibosha's head rolls out from the debris. We also find out that Vegeta is Vaboru's father. With this victory, Vegeta claims the throne for himself. Panning down, we see a few familiar faces in the audience. While we all pretty much knew, it's finally confirmed that this Vegeta is the King Vegeta we're all familiar with, who proudly shouts his title out to his people. He declares that under his reign, weaklings will not be tolerated. This seems to strike a nerve with the young Vaboru. However, tomorrow the Saiyans are to wage war on the Sufers to regain their freedom. At a kingdom not too far away, Dr. Raichi is addressed. The king of the Sufers, no doubt, tells the doctor that the monkeys seem to have chosen a new leader and that they have declared war. Raichi isn't too fazed by this threat. They are superior in numbers and technology. How could the Saiyans hope to be of any concern? Regardless, the king asks Raichi to resume the Hachiak program, but that program was shut down. The council deemed it to be an abomination, and it very well may be, but the council doesn't need to know about it. This is war, after all. Raichi agrees, but notes that it'll take about 4 years to perfect. The king wants to be clear, however. The sole purpose of the Hachiak program is to protect the baby project and to eradicate the Saiyans. With the instructions understood, Raichi adds the qualifier that it'll also be used to build a duplicate of his father, Dr. Mew. With the terms understood, the lone chapter comes to an end. This story was originally planned to be much longer, but the author never commissioned anything past the first chapter. So if you want to see more, let him know using the DeviantArt link in the description below. It looks like much more is planned for this character, and I would love to see the story continue.